guitar, there's Brian Koonin, and on bass, Jeff Carney, both played with me on my last tour. And on drums back there is Ray Marchica. Glad you guys are there, huh? And to my right is this most exquisite pianist that actually Diana Krall found for me, Tamir Hendelman, who's extraordinary. Thank you. We just played on the new album, and we just went to London together and did the Oprah show together last week. And the Grammy Award-winning producer who did the album with Diana and me, Tommy LaPuma's here. I usually don't like to introduce celebrities because I faint in my chair if anybody's about to introduce me. I just don't. But it's such a small room, you can't hide here, you know. So I'll just tell you briefly that the very talented star of Sex and the City and many other movies, Sarah Jessica Parker. I still have the shoe you sent me with the flowers, you know, I told you. So generous, thank you so much. The Academy Award winning, incredible, beautiful Nicole Kidman is here. Where are you? Almost met you in Australia, right? Australia. My friend, the brilliant designer Donna Karan is here with her granddaughter and daughter. Where are you? And I'd like to thank my team, Richard J. Alexander, Jay Landers, Dave Reitzis, Peter Morse, Peter Fletcher, Columbia Records, especially my longtime manager, Marty Ehrlichman, who has been in my life since I was 19. Believed in me right from the start. His office was a phone booth on the corner of 53rd Street and 6th Avenue with a roll of dimes. Yeah. My good friend, my dear friend, Sis Corman is here now. Sis was one of my surrogate moms. And we met in acting class when I was 16. And when I was 18, I said, well, I couldn't do something with them because I had to sing at a talent contest in the Village. And she said, I've known you 2 years and you never told me you could sing. But she said, sing for me and Harvey, her husband, who was a doctor. And I said, I can't sing if I see your face. I'm too shy. And so I turned and faced the wall. I used to have actually bad conduct. I had very high marks in school, but D in conduct, because I always said the answer if I knew it. I just couldn't wait to be called on. But D in conduct, because I always said the answer if I knew it. I just couldn't wait to be called on. But so that's true. When I turned back, they had tears in their eyes, and they went with me to this talent contest, and we walked into the club, and Sis and I were the only women there. We didn't know it was a gay club. Isn't that funny? I just wondered, is that odd? Anyway, I won the contest, and my salary was $50 a week, and all the London broil I could eat. They made great London broil, so I've been singing for my supper ever since. Now, what a journey this next extraordinary woman is on. She's devoted decades of service to so many nonprofit organizations, especially those concerning education and children. And she is the first woman to move from becoming our First Lady to United States Senator to Secretary of State. And as far as I'm concerned, there is only one more first for this woman. And we all know what that is. Who is Lea Michele? Now, as for her husband, we all know how well he took care of us during his presidency. Years of prosperity, respect around the world. And we know about his intellectual curiosity and his ability, extraordinary brain. But watching him this week at the Clinton Global Initiative reminds me of something truly rare in a human being, that his soul connects to the least fortunate among us, and he is as comfortable with them as he is with the most powerful leaders of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the 42nd, my lucky number, President of the United States, Bill Clinton. William Jefferson Clinton. Very funny. David Letterman, Jon Stewart, you're funny. And also here tonight is their daughter, their smart and very lovely daughter, Chelsea, and their beau, Mark. Hi. I feel Virginia's here too somehow. His mom. Another one of my surrogate moms. Before you were president, I sang for you at a fundraiser in L.A. where you told me that your favorite song of mine was Evergreen, which I was very flattered because I wrote the music, and I remember telling you, okay, if you win the election, I'll sing it for you at your inauguration. And I was extremely happy that I got a chance to do that. Thank you.